I just watched the Roosevelts on PBS. I loved it. If you get a chance to see it, I'm sure that they will repeat it many, many times. Eleanor Roosevelt once said this. She said, "You gain strength, courage, and confidence every time you look fear in the face." And how many things they had to fear. First, the Great Depression, then World War II. So much. Well, how about in our lives today? We may not have as big of things in the history of humankind as they did, but our storms seem quite big to our own human life. And when you're threatened by a storm of your life, you need to have courage, and that courage is something often you can't muster up on your own. You need the help of God. And when you have the help of God, you're able to stand there and look fear in the face, because you know that God is greater than your problem. Do you remember where a storm rose quickly on the Sea of Galilee, and the disciples were very, very afraid? Although they had seen Jesus many times perform miracles, the disciples feared for their lives, and so they turned to their master, and he calmed the winds and the waters. Sometimes we, like the disciples, feel threatened by our own storms of life. Thankfully, when we are afraid, we too can go to Christ for courage and for great comfort. Comfort in our mind, comfort in our soul, comfort in our body. My friend, the next time that you're afraid, remember the one who calmed the waves and the winds is also able to calm your heart and your mind. God will save you if you trust in God. And then, rather than feel so threatened by the daily storms of your life, you can face them with courage and come through every one with great safety, with great protection. In Matthew 8:26, it says, "He said to them, 'Why are you fearful, you of little faith?' And then he got up and he rebuked the winds and the sea." And here's the great line. "And there was great calm." And that's what I pray for your life. I pray that as you go to God, as you have God come through you, that there is a great calm.